maybe Philip Clark, seeing as you're there as the piano driver and one of the main organisers for the FLA, I suppose, and indeed the local branch. Do you think this band might take part in the FLA competition at the weekend?
Well, you know, I'll have a little chat with you after, Kieran, and if we get your blessing, we'll put them in.
I'm giving my blessing here now, and I think the band sounds fantastic.
Well, I consulted Maliki Bourke on my left here, and that goes well, we'll put them in. How's that?
That we'll watch out for that, we'll watch for the headlines. I must say, it's an incredible lineup of musicians in the Cayley Band. The Dr. Brian Galligan branch, of course, is your host of the County FLA here in Kilmarnock next weekend. Can you just tell us a little about Dr. Galligan himself?
Yes, I suppose Dr. Brian Galligan, first of all, he was a medical doctor, and he was very much associated with the music, and he was one of the, what we call the ear spraggery of Coates Clotrier, and we've actually a little monument down to him here in the town. He was a promoter of music and of song. He was a promoter of handball and all sorts of cultural things, and of the dance indeed as well. But he was primarily located in Cavan Town and in Ballinacria, excuse me, and in Kilmarnock. So we got the idea that we would need a big name behind us here, and what better one than Dr. Galligan.
There's no doubt about it, of course. Originally, was he born in the States?
He was, yes, he was, and he moved over here. I think he went to school in St. Pat's, and he used to cycle in now from Ballinacria there to St. Patrick's College.
And a great supporter himself of all things traditional, as you mentioned. He was there at the very foundation, at the very beginning of Coltis anyway.
He was indeed, yes. He was with them in Mullingar in 1951.
Now, the FLA here next weekend, it's well, I suppose that I mentioned at the start, this branch of Coltis are well used to running county FLAs at this stage.
Yes, this particular branch here has been active since 2008, when the branch of Coltis was formed in Kinnelec. And as you mentioned earlier on, we ran the FLA in 2009, 2010 and 2011, and we didn't take our finger off the pulse really since then, even though a lot of our members were involved on the FEC of the great three in a row All-Ireland FLA in Cavan Town. But we're back again, and we have the classes up and going, and we have music going well in the area, and we decided to take on the FLA for this year.
Now, you mentioned about the FLA, and of course, I would imagine that there was a great sort of kickback from those three great All-Ireland FLAs that were in Cavan Town. But what about before that, like going back in time, with some great names associated with traditional music in this area of County Cavan?
Oh, there certainly were, and you know, so dangerous to mention names. We had many, many local stalwarts, particularly many fiddle players, and we had tin whistle players and all. But I suppose if you just go down the road a little bit, one of the biggest names that you'll ever come across is the great Sean Maguire. This branch was involved in getting that monument put up to him there during the great years of the All-Ireland FLA.
Yeah, we certainly would talk a bit about that when you had put up that monument, a great local community involved in all of that. Now, I see a sign here, Traditional Irish Music Festival, Kilmarnock, in memory of Dr. Brian Galligan. But you run festivals to remember lots of different people associated with traditional music.
We do. Primarily, we run the Dr. Galligan one in April, mid-April each year. But we pick out a different musician from the area each year, and we run a festival to honour them. And the last one that we did was in honour of the great fiddle player from Nugent, which is just out the road, called Patsy Cook. And we ran one in honour of John Masterton in Ballymacue there before that. So next year we plan to run some for some more dignity.
No, I think it's fantastic. It's good to remember those who have already made their mark, let's say, in Coltis or in traditional music in the area. But the FLA then next weekend, I know there's a bit of a development in that we'll have Nia at the FLA, and I'll talk to Martin Donoghue maybe a little about that later. I see him in the audience here being very quiet actually tonight on Cayley House. But the FLA itself, what's going to happen over the weekend here in Kilmarnock?
Well, I suppose in a nutshell, we kick off with the official opening on the Friday night, and we have music, song, dance throughout the town, but also with the dancing competitions, and there are lots of entries in there, and that goes on in the hall and in the football grounds up there as well. And on Saturday, it's competition day. We run competitions in the school, and Sunday competitions as well, all the solo competitions. We do the group competitions on the Saturday. Mm-hmm. And then when we come to the Monday, I think that's when Nia really kicks in, because we have some great music, song and dance in the form of concerts and that, which Martin Donoghue is, I think we have stand for so much of the things that go on in this county. We were not to Martin Donohoe.
There's no doubt. I remember someone back in my earliest days heading to Cavan to meet this Martin Donohoe to do a Kelly House, and at that time, I don't know how many years, maybe 20 years ago, he said, you know, the Fla will come to Cavan, the All-Ireland Fla will come to Cavan. Not many people believed him at the time, but it did come to pass, and there's a legacy from that.
There is indeed, and I think that it's not just true in this branch, it's true in every branch throughout the county. The music, the song and the dance has got a great boost from that, and it's strong throughout the county, thanks be to God. And last year, you know, we had a great fla there in Swanland Bar for the first time, and we've also had great fla in Kilashandra, Swanland Bar, and any places that have been.
Now, we are going to invite a young man to play a couple of tunes, but you better tell us about him. That's Pádraig Bannon. Is he here somewhere? Pádraig is at the back. I see he has the crest and the Dr. Galligan CCE cultus t-shirt on him and the crest. So we're going to get Pádraig into that middle chair there for the concert flute players. That's the private place for concert flutes on the stage. But Pádraig has been involved in teaching in past years here.
He has. Pádraig's a great lad, and he's been involved in the music in Ghana and all that, and keep it going there. But we have been very fortunate to have him teaching the music here in the Dr. Brian Galligan branch, right here in the Railcoat Centre, and he's done a great job with the children. But I think it's getting a bit harder for him now because he's working up in Dublin, and just to relieve the pressure, James McGovern does the flute classes for us there now.
So Pádraig is getting used to city life, so by the sounds of all of that. He's going to play a selection of tunes for us now, actually, is Pádraig. And the first one is called The Boys of, is it Corncreeve? After that, we have Liffey Banks and then Miss Monaghan. Would you please welcome Pádraig Bannon? Thank you. That's the flute playing of Páirí Bannandale. A reminder that you're listening to Cady House from the Rail Talk Centre in Kilnaleck in County Cavan. We're preparing for the Cavan County Fla, which runs here in Kilnaleck next weekend.